So you want to start a random conversation with a complete stranger, but you don't know how, right?
Well,
watch this video until the end and you might just get something out of it. Have you ever had that moment where you wanted to befriend somebody and you wanted to start a conversation, but you haven't the slightest idea where to start? No worries. We've all been there. I'm gonna give you a couple of steps and tips that if you follow, no guarantees, but 90 to 95%, you might just become really good friends with somebody. So, without any further ado, let's jump straight into the tips. Tip number one, and it's probably the most important one, is to find a common ground. I'm going to give you a very popular example, which is, for example, the weather. If the weather is cloudy or, I don't know, dusty or snowy, you can talk about the weather, yeah. Why not? I'm going to give you another example, which is the location that you and your friends are at right now. فمثلا التقيت انت وصديقك يعني في مكان جميل مليء بالمناظر الطبيعية الخلابة او يعني فيها اشياء يعني تستحق المدح فيمكنك ان تتحدث عنها انت وصديقك لما لا. Say for example, this is a really nice place, isn't it? Look at that sculpture right there. It's wonderful. Or for example, look at the shape of that tree. It's strange, isn't it? And you can start a conversation about that. Tip number two, ask open-ended questions. And avoid yes or no questions. What do I mean by that? Open-ended questions are the kind of questions that encourage longer answers or longer responses. And avoid yes or no questions, meaning don't ask, for example, did you like that movie? And then your friend would, you know, reply by saying, yes, I like that movie. And yeah, the conversation is done. No, avoid that. Instead, for example, you can say, what do you think about the new movie? This is an open-ended question. Here, you are encouraging your friend to share his opinion about the movie with you. And the opinion, usually, it can be pretty long. So in this case, you are kind of starting a conversation of sharing opinions. Well done. Tip number three, be genuine and friendly. And I can't stress this enough. Because being friendly, showing emotions, smiling or doing different expressions based on the conversation, of course, means that you are really interested in your friend's opinion, which shows them that you really care about what they have to say. One thing that I love to do when conversing with my friends is to smile and constantly making eye contact, especially in a moment of conversation where they have important points or an important point to get across. I make sure to make constant eye contact to show them that I am genuinely interested in what they have to say. And also, try to use a friendly tone of voice. For example, okay, nice, oh really? Interesting. You see, these really show your friends that you are really and genuinely interested in what they have to say. Tip number four, listen actively and ask follow-up questions if the situation demands it, of course. I'm going to give you an example to demonstrate that. So let's say, for example, your friend told you that he or she fell off his or her bike yesterday. So here, instead of saying, say, for example, ask follow-up questions. Say, may I ask why you did fall off your bike yesterday? Or how did you fall off your bike? Or for example, say, oh no, did you hurt yourself badly? These are all called follow-up questions, which really shows interest in what the other person has to say and shows them that you are truly interested and truly care. Tip number five, and it's probably the last one, is to be mindful of personal space. Respect personal space. So what do I mean by that? Be respectful or respect your friend's boundaries. So avoid getting too close to them, you know? So for example, if you are, or if you see that you are getting close to them and they're, you know, slowly backing up, try to stay in your place, try not to get very close to them because they might not be comfortable with you getting close to them. So that's what I mean by be mindful of their personal space and respect their boundaries, simply. I have an extra tip that I'd be remiss not to mention, which is don't ask questions that are too personal, no matter how close you think you are to someone. You know? I mean, if someone does not really want to tell you about their secret, don't push it and don't keep pushing it. So if you think that you are going to ask your friend a question that is too personal, please give them like a heads up, or ask politely that, for example, would you mind if I asked you about this, this, and that? You know, so they'd be ready to decide whether they want to answer your question or not, you know? So yeah, these are all the tips that I have for you today. So if you follow at least, let's say, two of them, you'd be able to become friends with somebody out there. So hopefully you do follow them. And yeah, therefore, if you found this video helpful, please don't hesitate to subscribe to the channel, hit that like button, and activate that notification bell so you don't miss any future videos once they are uploaded to the channel soon, inshallah. And yeah, until I see you in the next video, inshallah, take good care of yourself, keep learning, and keep growing. All right, see you, talkies.